When police were called last August to this home in upscale Georgetown, the bathroom seemed the scene of a terrible accident. Viola Drath, a well-known D.C. socialite, was dead. As a journalist, she had written for many influential publications. She had kept company with the rich and powerful. Her husband, Albrecht Muth, told police he found the body, and according to Keith Alexander with the Washington Post, he gave a plausible story.
In the beginning, he would say that she fell and she hit her head, and that's what happened.
And it was a tragic accident.
It was a tragic accident. She was 91 years old.
Although Muth, at age 47, was 44 years younger than Drath, coming along after her first husband died, they had been married more than 20 years, united in part by a shared German background. Neighbors like Paige Robinson thought him peculiar.
And it's true that he would walk around in these outfits that were army outfits, and he would have a cigar, and he was a bit eccentric, for sure.
Did you think he was in the military?
No.
Friends like Warren and Sonny Adler say Muth was full of grand claims about his heritage and experiences.
He was like a German baron. He clicked his heels. He bowed. I think he had some connection with the United Nations, or at least that's what he told me. But I still had the impression that for her, he was a fish out of water. And I could not understand that relationship at all.
Police say their investigation turned up reports of multiple incidents of domestic violence against Drath over the years, and that Muth had twice been charged with assault. He was convicted in one case and the other was dismissed. And yet...
They had some things in common that she was able to make her feel young again.
You think that she really loved him?
She really did love him.
But within hours of the body being found, police were turning up evidence that suggested Muth felt differently. According to an arrest affidavit, Muth told them this was a marriage of convenience. He had no job, and Drath gave him a monthly allowance of $2,000, recently reduced to $1,800. In a search of the home, police found a letter Muth presented to his wife's family after her death. It was dated the day before her body was found, signed in her name, and instructed the family to hand over at least $150,000 if anything happened to her, according to the affidavit. And then the medical examiner dropped a bombshell. Viola Drath, he said, had not fallen. She had been beaten so badly that bones were broken and she had been strangled. Police picked up Albert Muth and things got strange. In court, even as his appointed attorney tried to argue that the evidence was not enough to tie Muth to the crime, he interrupted to say he wanted to represent himself. He went on a hunger strike. He suggested an outside killer was to blame for the murder, even though police say there was no sign of a forced entry. And he suggested he should be treated as a captured military officer, in keeping with stories he had told for years.
He claimed he was a general in the Iraqi army.
He claimed a lot of things.
He also claimed that he was a spy for for foreign countries. He claimed that he was of European aristocrat descent.
Is any of this true?
None of it is true.
Amid all that, the court finally sent the accused for psychiatric evaluation to see if he could even be held accountable for the horrible crime that happened here. And this psychiatric hospital, for the moment, is where he remains, undergoing tests to determine if he truly understands how his long, strange trip into D.C. society circles led him to face a charge of murder in the first degree. Tom Foreman, CNN, Georgetown.